Captain's log 1116.18. On course, on schedule, bound for Altair 6. The adventures will be incredible. Fifth grade, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the starship Enterprise. Its one-year mission to explore math, science, reading and writing concepts, to participate in incredible gaming adventures, to boldly go where no fifth grader has gone before. This week's academic accomplishments. In math, fraction concepts became clearer as students worked to make like units pictorially. The link to Module 3, Lesson 4 can be found in the small version of Mr. McCoy's weekly log. Students also had the opportunity to link math concepts to social studies and science topics as well. In reading, we sought to determine a theme from the details in a biography of Meriwether Lewis and William Clark, as well as in a play, A Surprise Reunion, featuring Sacagawea. In writing, student authors discover that they need to make sure they think hard about how to be inspired to do their best work. Writing well requires talent and knowledge and skill, yes, but also inspiration. We also discuss that learning is a bit like an onion or the rings in a tree, and that it pays off to stop once in a while and ask, am I doing everything I know how to do? Am I using all the strategies I know for powerful writing? In social studies, trekking backward even further into history, we looked at the origins of westward expansion as we focused on the Louisiana Purchase and the selection of Lewis and Clark to lead an exploratory mission. We also delved into a short biography of Sacagawea, and we compared the biographies of Charles Goodyear, The Mystery of Rubber, and Frederick Tudor, The Ice King. And in science, where is Earth located? We sought the answer to this question. Then the students designed a diagram showing the relationship between the Sun, Earth, and Moon. We also sought the answer to the question, what causes seasons?
Ma'am, who said anything about a fight to the death?
The Unit 13 spelling test will be given this Friday, November 16. The link to all of the words for the entire school year can be found in the small version of Mr. McCoy's weekly log. I'm heading to the transporter room to have myself beamed back down to the planet Altair 6, where Captain Kirk and Mr. Spock are about to engage in mortal combat. Also, The Indian in the Cupboard concludes this week. We will then move into The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe by C.S. Lewis. Here's an overview from the Amazon website. When Peter, Susan, Edmund, and Lucy are sent to stay with a kind professor who lives in the country, they can hardly imagine the extraordinary adventure that awaits them. It all begins one rainy summer day when the children explore the professor's rambling old house. When they come across a room with an old wardrobe in the corner, Lucy immediately opens the door and gets inside. To her amazement, she suddenly finds herself standing in the clearing of a wood on a winter afternoon with snowflakes falling through the air. Lucy has found Narnia, a magical land of fauns and centaurs, nymphs and talking animals, and the beautiful but evil White Witch, who has held the country in eternal winter for 100 years. The links to the read-alouds can be found in the small version of Mr. McCoy's weekly log. I'm on my way to Mr. Spock's quarters to talk to you about encouraging study skills. This article discusses a number of proactive ways to help you encourage study skills in your child. The first is help your child recognize the importance of great study habits. Isolate a nice quiet spot for studying. Be present when your child is studying. Be there. Don't necessarily do the work for your child, but just be present. and ask viewpoint questions when helping your child study, like what is your opinion about this topic? If you could do this differently, what would you do? That kind of thing. Be sure to check out the article, Encouraging Study Skills. The full length can be found in this week's edition. Three related articles, the first of which is Staying Motivated. There's an article giving suggestions for how to keep your child motivated during the holiday season. At least once a week, ask your child to teach you something that he or she has learned at school. When your child fails at a task, help him or her understand that this is a great learning experience. And ask your child, what did you learn by doing this project? Also, there's an article entitled Time Management with regard to completing homework each week. Break down your homework time. Help your child understand that he or she has a task that's due by Friday. How can I break down this task so that it's in more manageable pieces? Write in break times. It's important to take quick breaks to help your child refocus. And then encourage the stick with it approach. Never give up. You only fail if you quit trying. And there's an article called Competence. It talks about how you should focus on what your child does well, not on what your child does not do well. Help him or her capitalize on his or her strengths, and things that he or she doesn't do well will seem less important. Thanksgiving vacation begins on Wednesday, November 21st. For the full Liberty Oaks calendar, access the S'more version of Mr. McCoy's Weekly Log. Coming in 2 weeks, issue number 16, entitled The Fifth Grade Machine, to be delivered to you for the week ending Friday, November 30, 2018. Be sure you join us.